What is going on, people of the internet? Happy Chaotic here with the K, double R, and welcome back, or welcome if this is your first time visiting my channel, and welcome back to Star Wars Battlefront 1 2015 for Difficulty Tweak December. Difficulty Tweak, where I go back to play the games I've recently played on each individual difficulty, and I will not typically play a whole single player or campaign in one go or several videos, whatever the case may be, on every difficulty, just a few selective missions. And welcome to the Skirmish Fighter Squadron's Difficulty Tweak video. Today, I'm going to be doing Outpost Beta as well as Sarossa for two reasons. For starters, Outpost Beta because out of these other three maps below this one, it's one of the ones with very bright skies, good lighting, just all in all, just good view in general. I mean, they all got a good view, but what I mean by good view is it's just going to be easy to see. So the only difficulty will be, however, the bots are affected from me changing the difficulty. And then Sarossa, because it's a very cloudy map. So the lack of visuals may affect the difficulty a little bit more than just how I change the, well, actual difficulty. Then, lastly, I'm going to go back and play the match again on the hardest difficulty, but in first person. So, starting off with Outpost Beta, each difficulty, Sarossa, each difficulty. Then lastly, one more battle, Outpost Beta, last difficulty, first person, followed by Sarossa, same thing. Now let's hop into it. And of course, if you want to see some no commentary gameplay of this, link in the description down below for my second no commentary channel for no commentary playthroughs and video game preservation. Also, if you're the type of person that likes to get 100% completion on your games, I will leave a link in the description down below for a collectibles guide for this game. Now, there are no collectibles whatsoever in these skirmishes, definitely not in the fighter skirmishes of all things, but that doesn't matter. Whenever I play a game that has collectibles, whether I go for them or not, whether a specific mission or mission type has them or not, it doesn't matter. Or whether I'm playing What Did I Miss or Difficulty Tweak, and even for my second no commentary channel. For the second battle, I think I'll do Empire. But yeah, no matter what the case may be, whether I go for the collectibles or not, no matter the game, I'm always gonna leave a link for a collectibles guide. Man, in this fucking mode, you might as well not even pay attention to the map because you're gonna see red cones everywhere. Fuck. Waste that missile. Or a torpedo. I don't even know which one it is. They basically act the same in this game to me. Or any Star Wars game for that matter of fact. Fuck me, I didn't lock on properly. I keep forgetting that the missiles don't lock on the same in this game like they do in Battlefront 2. because I'm used to the Battlefront 2 controls more than anything. Now, I have tried out the multiplayer in this game, but it's mostly dead on console. Supposedly, it just straight up... Oh, shit. Supposedly, it's just straight up dead on PC.
Keep our transport out of danger. Engage all hostiles.
Which is disappointing, because I was hoping that maybe I can hit up my boy who has a PC, hop on, and see if there are any matches more lively than what I can get on Xbox. But, no, it's apparently more deader there than here. Which is a shocker to me. I honestly would have expected that the community would have done a better job at keeping it alive than EA, like they're doing with Battlefront 2, just with, like, you know, mods alone. And, I don't know, maybe for a short period of time they did. But, I guess even the modders could only do so much to keep the game alive.
Our transport is safely out of firing range. Good work!
Yeah, since I'm used to Battlefront 2 controls more than anything, and came way late to Battlefront 1, it just, you know, it almost feels weird, because it's like the same game, but not, because, well, that's literally the case. But just with the way my muscle memory is with the sequel, and then going back to this, kind of messes with my head a little bit. But I'm like, oh, why didn't this or that work the way I'm used to it? Oh, because wrong game.
Imperial squadron incoming. Locked in attack position.
And it really is disappointing that this game is dying so soon. Even given the shit I said in the last gameplay. Now, if by some miracle it ever has some sort of resurgence, I'll definitely hop back on. Hopefully get a chance to try out each individual mode, at least in the base game, because I don't have the DLC. And I probably wouldn't even buy it if it did have a resurgence. Unless I knew it was going to have a resurgence for, like, at least, I don't know, a good, let's say 5 or 6 months, right? Because then I could at least get 5 or 6 months worth of gameplay out of it. Whether it be just personal...
Nicely done. Oh.
Personal enjoyment, content for the channel, or even a little bit of both. Even if they were to do a price drop, to where, like, maybe all the DLCs were $5 in total, like, maybe I would buy it, which I would still have to buy the whole game first for that. For the sake of video game preservation, which you'd be better off doing that on PC more than anything for that, because you could just rip the ROMs out if you figure out how. And even then, that's a maybe. But I would only even be able to do that for, like, the single player stuff more than anything. Because unless people are actively playing the multiplayer modes, the DLC modes would be completely inaccessible. I'm pretty sure if you were to watch a review, oh shit, about this game, playing it today, if somebody was to say, oh, you know, like, let's say a reviewer reviewed this game right now, they'd probably say something like, you know, if you really want to buy it just for the sake of having it, you know, make sure you get it at a very good discount.
Ooh.
And don't waste your money on the DLC unless you just want it for the single player stuff, because you're not going to get anything out of the multiplayer any further with the DLC. Apparently, even when the DLC dropped, apparently the DLC modes weren't as popular as the base game modes. Or so I've heard. Thank you. Now, when it comes to the multiplayer, I'm primarily disappointed I missed out, mainly because I didn't get gameplay for video game preservation, and that's because I didn't get a chance to enjoy it for myself. I mean, a little bit of that too, but the first reason I mentioned is the primary reason more than anything. I forgot how these freaking matches would go on for a good minute.
Nothing over there.
Who's shooting at me? I don't understand.
Transport ship will be vulnerable on its way out. Shield it.
That's not exactly what I was going for, but oh, wait, what's that? I don't know. No, that's just a vehicle repair. Okay, where's... There it is. Fuck! I guess that's what I get for not slowing down. Oh shit.
Hostiles incoming.
Forgot about that.
Stay in there. Help is on the way. Our transport ship made it up.
Fuck.
The Imperial air defense is coming into range.
This is Red 6, standing by.
Oh.
about a minute left. Looking at the bot gamer tags, and I'm noticing there's one missing that I used to notice a lot back when I was getting a lot of the no commentary gameplay. Interesting. Oh shit! There goes the iconic sound. Fuck.
Imperials inbound. Mark an attack position.
Ooh, got you, motherfucker. That was worth it. Where the fuck is it? Where's the fucking special token? I'm over here dodging blasters. What the fuck?
The transport ship escaped in one piece.
I will ram you, motherfuckers. I don't give a damn. is crazy to me how you can pick it up and it doesn't count if you just happen to die in the middle of it. What the fuck was that about? What the fuck? Did it just... Oh, wow. It lost lock on as soon as I fucking launched the missile. Come on.
Lander shuttle down.
Shit, I'm just trying to get the camera to pull back a bit. Like, what the fuck? Ooh. What the fuck? Where did it go?
Shows an Imperial ship attempting to flee. Fire on it. Our transport is evacuating. Don't let them lock.
What the fuck? fuck with their aiming systems, and it's good enough. Still alive. Thank you. shit, we're already losing. And these motherfuckers are going hard. Not hard, but they're going pretty hard. Fuck. I got fucking Boba on me. God damn.
There's an enemy shuttle trying to escape. Engage at will.
It's that token. Ah, fuck. This is gonna be a tight one. Oh, shit. I'm gonna ram him. Come here, you motherfucker. I'm gonna ram your ass. Pause. Come here, you son of a bitch. Fuck! I couldn't fucking see it. I'm trying to stay above it. Still feel stupid for that fuck up, but it is what it is.
show them what we're made of.
What the fuck? Does it gotta do that every time something spawns in near the middle of the match?
Transport ship made it out.
Nice one.
Imperial air defense is coming into range.
Marine 7 in position. Standing by. Shuttle is down.
Fuck. Shit, so close. So close.
Imperials inbound. Standing by.
Okay, shit, I pissed somebody off. Ooh, I'm crashing to like two motherfuckers. Goddamn. I don't know if I actually did any damage in the process of crashing into him, but fuck it, worth it. I missed the token. Ah, shit. No. Maybe I'm fucking with their systems, cup. Shit. I never noticed that detail there before. Damn, that is nice. Wait. So is this a moon planet, or is that the moon to this planet?
Defend the transport shuttle.
What the fuck? Now that I think about it. Huh.
Transport ship is out of the danger zone. Good work.
Close. Okay, so far playing on these individual difficulties, when it comes to bots and the starfighters, well, I don't want to say that it's a situation of doing more damage or taking more damage, because I can't really say for sure. I would say maybe more accurate for sure on harder difficulties. also say that maybe on the harder difficulties, they just play harder. They play harder in a way where it feels like a match, an actually somewhat sweaty match, at least on the hardest difficulty. Sort of. Without it feeling like complete BS. Something I gotta point out is I find it interesting that my bots seem to be doing a little bit better than even the enemy bots. I mean, just look at that score. Damn, I didn't crash into a single one. I'm disappointed. Just as I was about to fire that fucking torpedo too. Shit.
Thank you.
that's what left him on 12 health, or he just had that before I crashed into him. I'm dead ass gonna try to crash into him again just because. If I can. Ooh. Almost had him. Fuck. Come here, motherfucker. I just want to crash into him. Where'd he go? Oh shit. Almost had him. Damn it! Yes, I got him! I think it actually took some health. I mean, barely like, what, 3 HP? I don't care though, that was fucking worth it, dude. Man, trying to hit him purposefully is hard. What the fuck? Can't see shit.
The transport shuttle is en route as expected. Great job. Thank you.
know, the more I play this, the more I realize I really do enjoy the controls of Battlefront 2's Starfighters more than I like the ones from Battlefront 1. And the controls are not bad, don't get me wrong. They're decent. As well as the other features. But I definitely like Battlefront 2 a whole lot more. As well as just how the battles play out. And the objectives. Come on. But one thing I will say I prefer in Battlefront 1 over Battlefront 2 is the fact that you can actually crash into other enemy vehicles and do damage. Of course, that'll do damage to you too, but I like that as a feature. Especially for immersion, it's very good for that. Whereas in Battlefront 2, you just, enemy or ally, you just phase through people. Nothing really happens if you try to crash into anybody. Of course, you can still crash into the objective, but that doesn't do anything to the objective at all. No damage or nothing. You just, well, at most, you deny the enemy a kill. And I gotta say, I wish that definitely transferred over to Battlefront 2. But it is what it is. Plus, I don't even know what a multiplayer match of this game mode would be like, because again, the multiplayer for the most part is dead. Now we're almost done with difficulty tweak December, and I'm gonna see how it goes down for the game Black. But before this year is over, I'm gonna at least do one more gameplay of Battlefront 1 multiplayer before this year is over, and before I uninstall this game, when I'm done with difficulty tweak for it.
You okay, Coco? Okay. If you're cold, lay down. Lay down if you're cold and you're tired.
Come on, not a single one.
Intensify efforts immediately. Thank you.
a new ship to tickle him. Where the fuck is that hero pickup? What the fuck? I came all the way down here for it. That was close. Alright, guys. I know I'm not talking a lot during this section or even the last section. And I want to apologize. I'm just so focused on the game right now. But with that said, I hope you are enjoying so far. And if you are enjoying this so far, make sure to leave a like. If not, leave a dislike and a comment telling me why. Because any and all interaction is good interaction for my channel and the algorithm. And any and all criticism can only get better. And of course, if you did like, subscribe to add a little dose of chaos in your life. If you didn't, please, please, please do leave your dislikes. Because your dislikes do matter. And I appreciate your time, even if you didn't enjoy it. But even then, I hope you guys stick around for just a little bit longer. Because right after this, it's the two more matches in first person, hardest difficulty. We're about to lose. And we're so close too, but it is what it is. Somebody want to do the math on this? It almost seems like my team still did. Okay, well, the lower half definitely did worse compared to the enemy team. The upper half did decent, but okay, yeah, the enemy bots definitely dominated a bit. So, for the most part, I've dealt with a little bit of BS in the hero and regular battles, a little bit of BS in the survival mode, especially that one Solus map. This one, the fighter squadron skirmishes definitely feel challenging, but they don't feel like BS. So I can say that. Alright guys, before I start this battle, I just want to make something very clear ahead of time. You're going to see me switch back and forth from third person to first person POV a lot. And that's because in not just Battlefront 1, but both the Battlefront games from DICE, when you play as a starfighter, the default POV is third person. And although you have the option to change to first person, you have to do it every time you hop into a match or you hop back into a ship when you die. Unlike the infantry, where you can probably preset whether or not you want it to be in first person or third person. Actually, I think you can only do that in part 2 and not part 1. But even then, at least with them, you can actually reset the preset of your POV. But for some reason with Starfighter, even in Battlefront 2, they didn't change that in a setting so where you can make first person the default POV for yourself. It's always going to be third person. And because of that, you're probably going to be seeing me switch back from third person to first person a lot every time I die. Also, if I do continue to fight in third person, that's simply because I'm just so focused on the game, it slipped my mind. And since it's the harder difficulty, it is going to be a bit, chaotic. So I might forget in the moment that, oh yeah, I just came back after dying, I need to go back in first person. This is the first person portion of the gameplay. Don't be surprised if it happens, because that did happen to me in the What I Miss gameplay as well.
Get ready. We have enemy fighters coming in. Keep them off our transport ships.
Now, I've mentioned this before, and I don't mind saying it again. Oh, shit. Since we're coming near the end for Star Wars Battlefront on this channel. But I honestly, truly prefer third-person POV more than anything. Just for the simple fact... I'm already stuttering. Just for the simple fact... that you have better environmental and spatial awareness. And for me personally, I just feel like I have more control over my ship in third person. You can just tell from this gameplay, I am not used to playing in first person at all. I very, very rarely ever play like this. Even in Battlefront 2. And pretty much Any game that has vehicles, land or air or sea, that you can play as, something like Battlefield or Battlefront or War Thunder, I'm more often than not just going to typically prefer and stick to third person. Once in a while, if I really prefer a challenge, or if I really want to immerse my... If I really want to immerse myself, I'll hop into first person. But for me, third person, if it has the option when playing in vehicles, I'm always going to take that by default. Because I just play better when I can see what I'm doing. Not to mention, I can know how close I'm getting to something or somebody. In certain games like GTA, of course, you can move your head when you go into first person, or Far Cry when you go into... When you go into a vehicle, you can move your head around and look around. But in games like Battlefront 1 and 2, you can't really do that. So if I want to look to the side, I have to move my whole fucking ship's position. There is no button to just look around. Not that it would matter. Fuck.
Here they come.
This is Green 6 responding. I'm going in.
Oh my god. And another thing is, I just got my sensitivity set for how I would play in third person. So I feel like if I was to start playing first person in Battlefront or even something like Battlefield in the vehicles full time, I would have to really set up a proper sensitivity for playing in first person.
Attempting to evacuate. Engage.
Damn it. Bro, I am dead serious on the fucking sensitivity thing. I would really need to mess around with it a little bit more so I can get a rifle playing in first person. shit. Joking. This shit is much more difficult than it seems. I mean, if you prefer first person over third person, then obviously the opposite is going to be harder for you in that regards. But man, this is really, really fucking challenging for me, even more than playing the hardest difficulty in third person. Yeah, we're not going to be able to get this one, Chief. We almost got him, son of a bitch. He's right there. Come on.
The aerial shuttle won't be making it to base. Nicely done.
That was fucking close.
Let's wrap this up fast.
Okay, now driving around with Han Solo shit is something else. Because, man, flying this thing is like flying the armed version of a fucking spaceship semi-truck. Or I guess technically a cargo ship more than anything, but yeah.
Keep our transport out of danger.
And I just mean in the sense of a big or wide vehicle that has a lot of blind spots. Gotta stay right above it. Protect it with my body. I gotta protect it with my body. Then hopefully it'll fuck with the targeting system. You know, I'm trying so hard not to crash into it too.
Our GR-75 transport escaped without taking heavy damage.
Somebody's getting fucking motion sickness right now watching my ass play in first person, I swear to God. I'm surprised I don't give my fucking self motion sickness. Come on, baby, hold together. That didn't do shit. Bullshit ass repairs my ass. Fucking what the fuck? I didn't repair a goddamn thing. Fuck. you can see just how much worse I played in first person from my fucking score alone. Damn.
Trying to leave the planet.
Alright guys, thank you guys so much for watching. If it sounds a little bit different, that's because I'm in a different position in my room. Sorry about the cutoff on my audio. Unfortunately, I had an issue with my microphone in the middle of recording. I swear, once Difficulty Tweak December is over, and I take care of some uploads for the next 2 weeks, beginning 2 weeks in January, I'm just gonna take a fucking break. Because I've been having so many fucking issues lately throughout this December. It's fucking ridiculous. And it's irritating. And I'm done fucking fed up with it. And near the end of this December, I am hopefully going to finally upgrade my PC. And maybe within early January, my microphone. But for the time being, until then, I have to work with what I have, and I'm gonna at the very least get Difficulty Tweak December done, as well as those uploads for those next 2 weeks. Before that happens, I'm really pushing to try to just get this stuff done. That way, that's cleared when I switch over to my new PC. I still have a lot of projects I want to get into. I got some pre-recorded shit that I gotta edit and upload, but I'm just saving that for January. And I'm just trying to finish up the games I'm trying to finish up for Difficulty Tweak December. I'm probably not going to be able to get to Halo Infinite anytime soon, which, for those of you who may be new to me or haven't seen any of the recent gameplays or joined me in the beginning of Difficulty Tweak December, I said I was going to go back and play all the games I recently played for this Difficulty Tweak December and play through each individual difficulty. This was including Siege, Star Wars Battlefront 1 and 2, Overwatch for a short period of time, Halo, and Black. I'm definitely going to be able to get to Black, but I'm not going to be able to get to Halo Infinite. I did not play Halo Infinite much on this channel as far as campaign goes. I did play a little bit of the multiplayer, and that's because I only do games I missed out on when I was young or in the prime, which is why I have a series called What Did I Miss? Though I will do difficulty tweaks for games that I have already played or that I didn't miss out on. So I don't mind at least doing that. And I will eventually do that, but that will probably have to come sometime in January. Later. Or in February, most likely. But for sure, I'm going to finish up on Battlefront 1. And hopefully, Black. But thank you guys through all my issues, to whomever's out there, so much for watching and sticking all the way through. Unless you're new to me, thank you for just sticking all the way to the end of the video. I really, really, really do fucking appreciate it. And I really, really do appreciate your time. Even if you didn't enjoy the video, I appreciate it. And please, do leave your dislike, because your dislike does matter. And it does help me. It doesn't matter if it's negative engagement. Engagement is still engagement on social media. It still helps me. And that just shows me you did watch. And let it be known, I do appreciate your time and your dislikes. See you guys next time for when I get into the Walker skirmishes. That's most likely going to be separated into two videos, so I can do two maps each difficulty. First as Rebels, and the second one will be doing it as the Empire. Unless maybe it happens to be a shorter video than I expected, but from my memory, Walker skirmishes could sometimes be as long as a survival match, so most definitely it's going to probably be in one video. For Rebels. It really is just as long as the survival match. It might be two for Rebels and Empire. Like two Rebel videos and two Empire videos. I want to break it into two videos, but it might end up being broken into four videos if it is as long as the survival battles. Anyways, see you guys next time. Once again, I really fucking appreciate your time. I really do. Chaotic out. Merry Christmas, and happy holidays, and a happy new year. Have a good one.